Hey guys, this is E with Scrapbooking with Me, and today we're going to start on the ephemera storage container. I won't call it container, it's actually going to be a journal. And what we're going to be using is old file folders. If you don't have old file folders, you can just make a page. I mean, I'm going to cover these anyway, so it's not going to matter. But I've got quite a few of the old cheap file folders that I got many, many moons ago. Some of them have been used and some of them haven't. So we're going to use these. And what you're going to do first is just cut that little tab off. I'm not going to use the tab. I'm going to put my own tabs on here. And excuse me if I just drank a citrusy drink and now I'm hiccuping. So I don't know what the deal is with that, but anyway. So what you're going to do is cut that file folder off at that last little score line. And let me see if you can see this. I doubt if, yeah, you might can see the score lines. See, it's got little score lines on one side. There's one, two, and there's the last one. And you're going to cut that file folder off at that last one. And you're going to leave this little piece right here. All right, I'm going to do another one and show you. Let me grab another one. Oh, I've got a mess. All right. I'm just putting that in there, and I'm going to cut that little tab off right there. And then I'm just sliding it through. And sometimes I have to actually fold on that line in order to see it, because I can't see it. There we go. You can probably see yours, maybe. So on that last score line on this side, and as far as I know, all of them have the score line on there. It's just so they can expand. But if you don't have a score line on yours for some reason or other, we're leaving 3/4 of an inch from the factory score line out. And we're saving these parts because we're going to be using those too. So we've got two of those cut. Now, I will tell you this. There is no way, no way that I'm going to get this project finished in one video. And you know I craft as I go, so I don't have a finished project to show anybody. So I hope that's not disturbing for everybody, but I'm making this as I'm going along. I don't have a pattern. I didn't do a trial run before. I'm just making this as I go along. A lot of times I make things up as I go along too. Now I will tell you on these, I have got a couple already made. Oops. Using wet glue is not good because it takes it so long to dry on this, and it kind of warps just a little bit, warps your paper, which I'm going to put these under some heavy books, so it's not going to matter. But I would use a glue stick or a glue that's maybe Fabri-Tac, some kind of glue that's not so wet. This is what I tried art glitter glue with, and it didn't like it. It just did not like it. So go ahead, and even though I hate glue sticks, I do hate glue sticks because I get it all over me, I'm going to use it anyway. First, let me find a piece of paper that I'm going to put in there. Now, what I'm doing is I'm using my scrap paper. I just drug out a file folder that has some scrap paper in it, and I'm just using scrap paper. I'm not even going to worry about what it is, where it came from. I'm just going to kind of make sure that it, you know, doesn't clash too bad, but I'm not going to worry about that too much either, because we're going to be covering some of this with our pockets, so I'm not going to worry too much about it. Okay, I'm going to grab my glue stick, and I use one of these little cheap three-ring binders. This is not a three-ring binder. One of these little cheap binders that I get at Walmart every year when they start back-to-school stuff. I get them for like 29 cents. I use these when I'm going to do a project on that I don't want glue or paint or ink or whatever on my table. And I don't have any old book pages. I wish I did. I'll put a plea out there to you guys. If anybody has old book pages, or if you have old books that you want to get rid of, I've got a project that I'm trying to do, but I can't do it without my old book pages. And I don't have any more. I've had some years ago, but I'm completely out. I don't have any. And I need some to do a project that I think you guys would really, really like. But it calls for old book pages, and I don't have any. So if you have some old book pages or old books that you want to get rid of, I will be happy to buy them from you or maybe trade something out with you from our store, give you a store credit, anything like that, that we can make a deal. Let's make a deal. We can do that. All right, I think I've got that on all of this. Now I'm going to put this down. This was Graphic 45 Flutter. Now, some of the Flutter collection I absolutely did not like. This paper is actually very pretty. But the ones that I covered this with, that I love, the butterflies. That I do not like. It's ants. Whoa. That one I like. That one I do not like. It's some kind of weird bug. Looks like a stink bug to me, and I don't like it. But I'm going to use it up because this is a good place to use up those papers that you're not really crazy about. This is the only one I had left of this, even though I like it. I didn't have any more left, so I'm just going to use it. All right. Wipe my mat off. So we've got that on there, and I don't trim mine first. I put it on, and then I trim it. But you can use a credit card or just something flat to press it down to make sure that the glue is going all the over the place. This little end right here, I leave it at a square. I do not trim that off. You can round yours off if you want to. I may end up rounding mine. I'm not sure. I'm not to that point yet where I need to make that decision. But I just use my bone folder, and I go back and forth over that and just make sure that all of that glue is pressed out there really well. As a matter of fact, I'm going to put this one on here. If it gets glue on it, that's just a plus. There we go. So we've got that one down, and see, that lays a lot flatter than putting that wet glue on there. It just doesn't like wet glue. Okay, we're going to save this piece because I'll show you what we're going to do with that in a minute. And I think that's all of my Flutter collection. Now, I've got the Santorini paper. So I'm just going to pull out some of those because I've not used all of these. And they don't have to match. Remember that. Keep that in mind. It does not have to match. Because these are going to be separate pages that you're going to be doing separate things with. So just grab a few. I'll use this side. I wouldn't use the side with the shiny on there. Just because your glue's not going to stick real well to that. I can use that one. And I don't know how many pages I'm going to put in this. Quite a few, probably. And I'll grab one of these. And that'll be what we'll do for now. So, we're going to mix some Graphic 45 with some Prima. And it's going to be just fine. Now I'm going to grab my notebook again. Go over this. Make sure you get it at the edges. That's where you want to make sure that you get your glue. Right at those edges and right up at the edge of that. So I kind of go around my edges first. I may have to fold that paper over. It's sticking. Let's just go ahead and do that. And make sure that your, what is this thing called? This is called a glue stick. Make sure that your glue stick is a good quality glue stick so that your paper is going to stay there. You don't want your paper turning loose over time. This is a Pioneer glue stick, and I've found that they're pretty good. Not had any trouble with them so far. Okay, I think that's all the way around. And we'll just grab one of these, doesn't matter what. And then I just line it up at the bottom and line it up with that first score line, because you want to leave this little flap open. So just line it up with your score line. Make sure that little flap can still fold, that kind of thing. And then you just want to press it down really well, especially at the edges. Okay. All right, and then we'll trim the excess off. You ever have those days where you just feel like you can't get everything together? That, everything just seems to be piling up on you and you just can't get it together and you don't want to do any of it, but yet you know you need to do a lot of it. That's been one of my days today. I'm starting this video really, really late. Should have got it up early this morning. Okay. So there is a page covered, and we'll cover another. My daughter, my youngest daughter's birthday is tomorrow. She will be 38. Then in 2 weeks from tomorrow, my oldest daughter's birthday. And of course, they both want their daddy to build them something. They love for their daddy to build them whatever. It doesn't matter what, as long as he's built it, they love it. So he's gone to town to get some things to build with, some wood that he needed to build some shelves and things. So then tomorrow we will try to, I think we're just going to get together outside so that all of us can, which it's not that many of us, it's only 10, so as long as we stay apart a little bit, we're good. But I think we're going to get together outside and just do a little grill out, and I'm making chocolate pie, homemade chocolate pie, and homemade strawberry pie, because that's her two favorite pies. She doesn't care anything about a cake, so that's what we're going to do tomorrow. So I've got lots of things that I need to get done today so that we can get over there tomorrow to her and celebrate her birthday. Since we can't go out anywhere, we usually take them out to eat, but we can't go out to eat because of the virus. So we will just celebrate the only way that we can right now and be happy that we're together. Now, I am still, don't get worried if I haven't done your project yet. For those of you who have requested a project for our, quarantine, list that we had, don't be upset if I haven't got to that project yet. I'm still going to do them. I'm still going back and forth and doing them, but I'm just trying to add in a few more videos along the way. So I think we'll put that one on there. I've got a couple coming up this week that should cover two or three people, because two or three ask for the same things. And then we will be starting our May challenge, the 1st of May. So I've got to get the details worked out on that. so that I can put a video up about that. We will be giving away, I think we're going to give away a prize a week. So that will be, what, 4 prizes? I think that's what we're going to do. So hang around for that. Keep your eyes open. I may put this one on this side. And it will be a 31-day challenge, so that means every day, whatever I come up with, every day you have to let me know. And I'm not sure yet. I haven't got all the details worked out. I started to put up, you know, you can do a video, but then I know there's a lot of people who watch me that don't do videos. So then I'm thinking about pictures of projects. So I'm trying to come up with something that will include everybody and not just a few. So if you have any ideas on that, you can leave them in the links below. I've got a few ideas, but it wouldn't hurt for me to have a few more. I welcome all suggestions. Now, I'm going to need to make sure that I'm putting this the right way. That's up. And I hope I didn't put that one a little while ago upside down with me talking. If I did, we're going to leave it. It's going to be okay. There we go. So this is all I'm doing. This is all that I'm doing. We're going to do our pages first, and then we're going to do our cover. And the cover is going to be a little bit different than some of the covers that we have done in the past. But it's going to be easy enough that you can make it. I'm going to show you step by step how the cover's done. But we will do it last, after we finish with all of our pockets. And each one of these pages is going to have 2 to 3 pockets on it for embellishments. And they're going to be clear pockets so that we can see through them and know what we have in each pocket. I don't want to put paper pockets because then you couldn't see inside to see what you had. So we're going to use some plastic. I call it plastic. It's some page protectors, old page protectors that I've had forever and a day from a company that I used to work for. And I've not used them, but I figured out this is a good way to use them up. Okay, that is another one. Isn't that pretty? I like that. Okay, we're going to do one more, and then I'm going to show you how we put together some of the pockets and what I'm using. I love that paper. That's so pretty. We may use it for one of our pockets. I think I can glue on the ends and we'll be good. Okay, so there is that side. Oh, I started to say I put that upside down. But I didn't. And then we're going to glue this page on. Right side up. I think we'll use this side. I like the other side, but I have to remember that this is a ephemera book, so a lot of this is going to be covered. Oops, that's a little bit close. There we go, and we'll trim this one off. All right, we have a good start on our pages. That's 3, 4, 5. That's not gonna be as many as we're gonna put in our book, but that's a good start. And that's the way to show you how you can make them. So drag out all of those old file folders and just get started gluing some of your old scrapbook paper on them. Some that you're not really interested in using anywhere else. And then I'm going to show you what I'm making my pockets out of. These were some old page protector things that I got when I worked with Creative Memories. I worked with them many, many years ago. And it's that plasticky. It's not really acetate, it's kind of a plastic on both sides. And I don't want to put this whole thing down because I don't like that brown behind it. So what I'm going to do is cut, and this is using what you have. I'm going to cut right down through there. So just drag out your plastic, your acetate, thin acetate it would need to be. Now, I have seen some people make these and they used vellum for the pockets. Or I'm a little bit scared about using vellum because I don't think it's strong enough to hold. But I've seen lots of them made with vellum and they seem to be holding up. So if you want to use the vellum, if you have vellum that you want to use, that's fine. You can use that too. So see, once I separate that, oops. Separate it. Is the word. Once I separate that, then I've got nice pages of just the right strength of plastic. And don't worry, this is a canvas. You can see it's kind of a canvas. I won't be throwing that away. I'll be using it on something. So I've cut a bunch of these apart, and then this is 9 inches wide, and it's 12, no, it's not 12 long. How long is it? They're 11 3/4 by 9. So what I have done is I've just used some of these scraps that I have here, just like, let me grab one, just like, let's say this. This is about 3 inches wide. Yep, 3 inches, and I just cut them down to 9 inch, and then I take this plastic, and I just cut me a strip that's the same size, 3 by 9. Then, so let's go ahead and do that. Let's cut this down to 9 inches. Cut that right there. Got that cut down to 9, and then we need to take, well, here's a piece, we'll just use this one. Let's cut this one down to, no, let's don't cut that one down, we might use that on another one. Let's cut this down to 3 by 9, so 3 inches right there. And this cuts really good with your trimmer. And then we'll do 9 inches. It's just hard for me to see 9 inches right there. So there's 3 by 9, and I'm saving these little pieces. I don't know why. I may use them, I may not, but I like to save things like that. So see, this piece of plastic goes right on top of that, just like that. Now, like I said, I have seen some people that did these little pockets like this with vellum. They just put vellum on here. Some people have used just the plastic with no backing and just sewed the plastic down on here. But I didn't want to do that because to sew this plastic down on here, this whole sheet would have to go in my sewing machine, and I don't want to do that. That seems like a lot of maneuvering, and when I turned it this way, this is too long to go in between my foot and the end of my sewing machine. So what I have done is I came up with my own way to do this. I am putting the plastic down on a piece of the paper, and then I am sewing. Well, first thing, let's just do this. I take my art glitter glue, because on this you can use a wet glue. And I know these flowers are running the wrong direction, but there again, this is going to have ephemera in it, so a lot of this is not going to be seen. I'm putting just a little bead of art glitter glue around the very, very edge of three sides. One long side and the two short sides. Okay. Then I'm taking my plastic and I'm putting it right down on top of that. Just like that. Then if you just let it sit like that, it's not going to stick well. But if you will take your bone folder or a credit card or something, even your thumbnail, just anything that's going to press that plastic down into that paper and into that glue, and press it down all the way around. Don't worry if some of your glue squirts out. All we're doing this for is just to kind of hold this plastic in place until we can sew it. And yes, I'm going to sew mine. Now, I know some of you don't have a sewing machine. Some of you don't want to sew, don't know how to sew. If you don't, then just make sure that you use a good glue around through here and then glue it down like this. I saw someone that took the acetate that she was using and she roughed the acetate up and then put glue on it, and she said it helped fine. This is being plastic. I think it will hold okay, but I'm not sure. So you may have a glue that would hold well on plastic. This is holding pretty good, as long as, you know, I don't know if I put pressure on it, if it would hold real well or not. Now, all I'm doing is trimming off a little piece of that plastic that was sticking up there that I got probably cut a little crooked. But I'm going to let that dry. Don't put it in your sewing machine until you let it dry. So let's grab one that's already dry. This one is a bigger one. This one I made 4 inches by 9. And see that I've glued it, but the glue has already come loose on the end. So the glue's not going to hold, or this glue is not. You may have a glue that will hold. This glue is not holding. This one I glued down earlier this morning too, and I don't think it's going to hold. No, it's not going to hold either. But I'm going to stitch around it. Now, I'm going to use this little sewing machine that I got from Magic Fly. This will do fine on this. If you've got a regular sewing machine, by all means, use it. I'm just grabbing this one right now, and I'm going to use it. The only thing about this one is it doesn't do a backstitch, and you really need to backstitch up here at the top so the stitching doesn't pull out. But what I'm doing is I'll show you how I'm remedying that. This little sewing machine is very, very inexpensive. I'll leave a link below. It's not expensive at all. So for anybody who doesn't have a big sewing machine, you can always get something like this. And if you want to do some stitching, this is just going to make this hold. Now, I'm going to mute the video while I sew around this, because it's a little bit loud and a lot of people complain about that. So all you're going to do, and don't worry about running your stitching straight. Mine's not straight because this little thing kind of moves around a little bit. But you're going to kind of have to feed this through because your foot is going to try to hang on this plastic. So I just kind of push it through there. And just as long as I get some stitches in it, that's all I'm concerned with. Need to make sure that you've got a good amount of thread at the end back here because we're going to be using that. And then you're ready to go. When you get to the almost to the end, stop while your needle is down and turn it, and then you're going to sew down through here. And then I do pull quite a bit of thread through. I pull a good amount of thread through so that I have a good piece of thread on either end. Then, and since I don't have a back stitch on that little sewing machine, what I do is I take my thread and I tie knots right here on the end. That is going to serve for a back stitch. Just tie some knots right at the end. And I tie about three. I pull them pretty tight. And then I clip that off. And I leave just a little bit there. And then I put just a little bead of glue on that and press it down on that knot. And when that dries, it's set. So I do that on both sides. So if you have a little sewing machine like that that doesn't backstitch, this is the way that you can take care of that backstitching. Just tie some knots at the end. Like that. And then I go ahead and I cut it off just, I leave about a half an inch maybe there. And then I just kind of press that little knot down and run my little bead of glue on there. And I know you can't see that, but see my knot's pressed down and then I've got my glue there. And that's it. Now the thing that you do need to do is don't put glue on these and then put it straight in your sewing machine. It will clog up your needle. Let that glue dry. Even if it's not going to hold, let it dry. It'll hold your plastic to keep it from slipping all over the place. And that's the main thing that we're doing with this. Now, what we're going to do, and the reason I chose different light colors to go on here is this is a very dark background, and I don't think that you would be able to see the ephemera that was down in there if I just left that dark background. So I'm kind of just using up some scraps, and see, that is an ugly paper, is it not? I know somebody might like bugs, but I don't. And then what I'm going to do is glue this down on here. Now, on this one, I'm just putting a 3-inch one. And I think this is a 4-inch or maybe 5. This is a 5-inch one. This one will be for my bigger ephemera, my tall ephemera. And then this will be for some of the short ephemera. Now, I'm also leaving the back open. So I've got a pocket here and then a pocket in the back. So I can, let me grab a piece of paper. So I can put something in the plastic like that. So let's say that was my ephemera. Or I can put some taller things in the back that would stick up maybe to here so that I can have those in there too. So I've got two pockets there instead of just one. And then this one, of course, we'll put it down here so it'll be for the taller things. You wouldn't want to put short stuff in this because it would slide down in there and then you'd be fighting trying to get it out. So we're going to put this right down at the bottom. When I get finished with these, I'll set these under some heavy books, and that will flatten all of them out. They're good and sturdy like they are right here. They're nice and sturdy. Now what I do on here is I run my art glitter glue, and I run it right down where I sewed and out at the edge. I just kind of run a bead on those stitches and then out at the edge. And that is going to help hold those stitches in so that that doesn't come apart. Because when I make something like this, I want it to last. I don't want it to tear up in a, you know, week or two. I want it to last for a long, long time. So I'm running it on that, on those stitches. And then right, if I went crooked, I run it right up at the edge, which I did go crooked a couple of places, but like I said, that doesn't matter. Okay. Then I'm just going to take this and glue this down, and I'm going to put this one right at the bottom. Just like that. And here again, you're going to have to press this glue into the paper underneath. Bone folder. There we go. So I'm pressing it in just as tight as I can get it. Press it down, spread it out, making sure that it goes up inside those stitches, the stitch holes, and then that's going to be there for a long, long time, hopefully. I think it will be. Okay. So there we go. Got that down. This one I put on earlier this morning, and you can see how, I mean, it's nice and tight, nice and glued. It's not going anywhere. That's all that you need to do to get started on your ephemera book. Drag out your old file folders. Find some plastic, even those little plastic page protectors that you buy at Walmart, those would be fine too. If you've got some of those, any kind of thin plastic, then drag out those old scrapbook papers that you're not completely fond of, that you don't want to use on anything else, and let's make some ephemera pockets. Now, I'm going to grab some ephemera and put in here. Now, I have some ephemera in these that I've had in these for a long time, and it stayed over there in a cabinet, and I never used it because I'd forget about it. I'd forget I had it. So I'm going to put it in this. If I have this book near me, I am going to be able to use my ephemera because I'll see it. This is something that someone made me one time. I think it's absolutely gorgeous. And see, I forgot I even had it. So I'm going to put that down in there. Again, something that someone made me. No, I think I actually made those myself. That's some cute ephemera. And see, that could go in the back right there because it would still stick up that I could see it. Now, all my tags and things like that, I'll put in another place. I'm not going to put them in the same place. We've got butterflies. I'm going to put all my butterflies on another sheet too, probably that other sheet that I have. I've got tickets that I can put somewhere. There's another butterfly. There's some little jars that I cut out. There's some pieces of ephemera. When it's just random pieces like this, I'll probably just stick a lot of these down in here. That's cute. There's a little piece. There's a piece that someone made me a while ago. There's some tickets. More tickets. See, I have all this that I need to be using, and I forget that it's over there. When I'm sitting here crafting, I forget it's over there. So I don't use it. There's a wood butterfly. And there's some more little coffee. What is this? A coffee cup and a... There's some little books. I'm going to take that sticky off the back because that would stick to everything. Stick that down in there. And If they've got sticky on the back, you can just put a little piece of that plastic on the back and stick them down in there. That one has kind of got a lot of sticky on there. I may use it for something else. Then I've got hearts here. I've got more tickets. And I haven't even got everything printed out that I have purchased through digital files or things that I have made digitally. I don't even have all that printed out because I really had nowhere to keep it. So now I will. There's another cute little coffee cup. And see, with them sliding right there, I can see what's in there. Now that's Christmas. I don't want to put Christmas in here. This is fall. All of this is fall ephemera. So I think it is anyway. Let's see. No, it's not. That's not fall. That's not fall. That's not fall. Maybe some of it was fall ephemera. Or maybe I labeled it wrong. These I need to use. It's a cute little file folder. See, all of this needs to be used up. That is fall. That's fall. That is fall. So I'll make a page where I just put my fall ephemera. But here's a lot of these that are cute that need to be used. I'm going to kind of layer them. And I'll put these down in here. And I'm not going to fill all of this up. I'm just kind of showing you how we can use it. You can put, if you've got some that's still in the bags, you can put the whole bag down in there. That's fine. I'll leave that for a little while. But I'll probably end up taking those out of the bag so that I can see them a little bit better. Face them all forward. But that is just how we're going to use this ephemera folder. Just like that. Now on some of the other pages, I'll put some little short pockets so that I can put all my little tickets and things in those short pockets. And then I'll label these. I'll put us a little label right here so that we can have them all labeled so I'll know what each one has in it. Like I'll have one that says butterflies and one that says tickets and one that says jars, one that says hearts, things like that, so that I can just flip straight to it when I'm looking for something and I'll have it like that. So your homework tonight, I always give y'all homework, don't I? You thought you was out of school. Your homework is to drag out those file folders and cut them up like I did. Drag out that old paper. Cut that old paper up and use it. Now, if you don't have file folders and you don't want to go to town and pick up a box, then you can just put two sheets of this paper together. Just make them. I'm making mine 9 by 11, but you can make yours any size that you want. Just glue two sheets together so that it'll be nice and strong. The file folder just gives it a little bit extra. And then you need this tab here. So you're going to need to cut this way. If you're just using paper, you're going to need to cut it at 9 3/4. And then score it at 3/4. So that's going to give you that extra little tab right here. Because this is what we're going to glue into our spine to make our attachment for the pages. Okay. So tonight, drag out all of that. Start putting your covers on your file folders or making your pages. And then you can go ahead and cut some plastic up, cut some backing up, and we'll go ahead and make some of those. Tomorrow we'll come back and we'll start putting all of this together and then start adding our ephemera into it. Because you can see, even though I hate the backing on this, see, you don't see a lot of it once you get your ephemera in there. But I can see my ephemera. I know what I have. Okay? All right, guys, that is it for today. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you're looking forward to making this as much as I am. I can't wait to get all of my ephemera sorted out and all of it put together. I'm really, really excited about it. So we will talk to you guys tomorrow, and we'll come back and we'll put this together. And then I have another project that I need to work on. And again, like I said, if anybody has any old books, old book pages, anything like that, old magazines that have some type in it, anything like that, let me know and we'll see if we can make a trade of some kind, because I really need some book pages, old book pages, in order to do this next project that I've got coming up. All right, we will talk to you guys later. Thanks so much for watching. Bye-bye.